Hello YouTube, welcome back. Just to say that someone swings the door open in the background. Welcome back. We are currently leaving Vito Scaletta's house. And we are going to head to Joe's apartment and hello to you too. Prick. We are currently leaving to go to Joe's apartment, which I don't know where we could see my hair. I did not know that.
What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business, asshole.
No. Oh, yeah?
Come on, Junior. I'm gonna take you to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on, show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse.
Ah, that's cheating. I'm still learning. Hey, cheater. Stop cheating.
Please, Vito, this isn't your problem.
I'm holding X. There you go. Okay, now we can take it.
You'll get yourself into more trouble, Vito.
Okay, so this is gonna be a dodging match.
Stop, please. Vito, what are you doing?
Yes, I'm down. There we go, pure knockout, first try.
Yeah,
come on,
right.
Use the box.
Get the fuck out of here! You're gonna be sorry. The both of you.
Both of you.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark. Thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
Here we go, it's good old Joe's. He's this way. Select, there's no touchpad in this one. Yeah, I don't really need it for that much. He's not far away, is he? I'm gonna cut through here. Hold L1 spring. What's up with L1 and sprinting in games?
Is it fixed yet?
Actually, I guess it's just easy access having L1. I just thought there's something cool you could do back here, I remember. I don't know why this just pops in my head.
It's cold in the car, too. Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
Get done and over on quickly.
I remember this blew my mind when I first did it.
Yeah. Well, if you're as good with a wrench as you were with your mouth, we could have this damn thing fixed already.
You are so useless. It's no wonder the army wouldn't take you.
You had to bring that up again, didn't you?
Ethel's husband, Frank, he's a fighter pilot. Margaret's husband, Charlie, he drives a submarine.
I'm warning you.
My husband? Oh, he's a 4F. He works at the grocery store.
You know what? Fix it yourself then, you lousy bitch!
And then Vito casually walks along and repairs the engine.
Hey, need a hand?
Sure do. Hope you're better at this thing than my good-for-nothing husband.
There we go. All done. I just needed to screw a couple things in.
Really? Well, thank you very much, handsome.
Don't mention
it. Okay, now we go again. Sorry, I just really wanted to do that. Because it's something that just amazed me the first time I played this. Because there was never really a game where you could just interact that much with the environment, and now it's more of a casual thing. But it wasn't a casual thing back then. Yeah, I'm going this way outside. Is it this door? Yes, it is. Keep on going.
Excuse me, ma'am. Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
I should probably be going through this. Oh wait, to the right there. Probably should be going through this game slower to actually interact with everything. But Mafia 3 comes out quite soon, so I kind of want to finish this. Well, at least finish the series.
Not at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. Why do we have to stop when we can all have fun?
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. And you know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
I never understood that saying of the working man's a sucker, because
you made
surely all working for your money.
In the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me.
Go on, Jay.
So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy, Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
No, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey, thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
I surely will do. I think it might be difficult for him to hear me through a TV screen a little bit there. Didn't do anything. Not at all. I think this is our first time driving. Yes.
Hey,
that's not where the boat could work.
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over
there
on the right.
God's sake. Don't be so close.
No.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
Jeez, it is icy.
Hey, Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
Speed limit. Okay, that's 18. Speed limit.
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it? You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it. Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's.
He's gonna open door for me.
Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a
Joe.
New customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
Retire,
Bay.
Retire, please. How are you? Papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army would bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
So, a lot of picks must have things underneath it. Now.
Here, take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins one by one. When all of the pins are set, just turn the wrench and the lock. It's easy.
See you around, Giuseppe. Say Benedict.
Easy, huh?
Don't worry, you'll get the hang of it.
What?
I do it all the time when I lock my keys
yeah,
in the car.
I was kind of hoping I had something else.
See you soon, Vito.
Yeah.
Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
Of course, honey.
Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Here we go. So a natural light.
Possible Grand Theft Auto.
Step on it.
Yeah, let me drive then.
Copy that. Vehicle theft in progress.
Oh Jesus.
It's not over yet. Lose him.
Difficult to control.
Roger that.
Can you strain up? There we go.
So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services
look at that.
We're looking for.
Hey, what? Hey, is he chasing
cheap?
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body shop. I know the guy who runs them. Park right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
How can I help you?
New license plate. For you, no problem.
Now it's changed.
There you go. Give her a couple of...
Is Joe paying for this? I think he is.
Take your pick, pal.
Let's get some cool looking ones. Let's get them. They look cool. Repair the car, basic tuning, let's improve that. Repaint.
You can paint it any color you like.
Let's pick a darker color. That looks cool. Yep,
He's paid for all this.
Alright, next you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. I probably have some work.
Fucking move.
Alright, where is he?
I am a car. You are people. Move.
Hey, who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
You kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants.
Look who's
hey,
here.
Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you can wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bath.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know? Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruski, but don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your, supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike. You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs these days?
Jesus Christ.
Plenty, and who knows if they can even get this filth out.
You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a mall in your neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
$400.
All right, deal.
Alfredo, come on, let's go. Andiamo. Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, eh? Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out. Here you go. Aim for that old wreck over there.
Here we go. Sorry, I hit the tire there. How is this tire not going down? It's fucking invincible.
Hey, you ain't a
there you go.
Shot. Hey, Vito, see if you can hit the gas tank.
Yeah, it's in the big white thing. Disgusting. Alright, he keeps creeping up. There you go.
Can I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Polak joke there, but I'll leave it alone.
Oh yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
Alright, that's enough shooting. We got work to do.
Look how many bullets I've wasted now. Oh, your phone, you prick. Get in the car.
The way we came in and get on the main highway going west. Don't go back through the city.
Right, he means not coming out the way I came in that place, because that did not happen.
Go right up here. So how's it feel to be back?
Good. I feel a lot better with some money in my pocket.
Hey, oh shit, I'm on the wrong side of the road.
Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Oh, fuck.
I was just fucking.
I was thinking I was in.
Don't worry about the money. This little job is just the beginning. Pretty soon you'll be rolling it.
Yeah, for Hawkeye, so, please.
Same
to watch out.
The same shithole it was when I left.
No, the place actually ain't too bad now.
Shit. How the hell that happened?
All the moolies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole, Vito. Right. I've only been gone a couple of years. Gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply like rabbits. What are you gonna do? It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there. What's their fucking name? The Beamers, the Boomers, something like that. I don't fucking know.
Oh, that's just fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope and kill each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you. And even if they do, that's why I gave you that pistol.
Oh, by the way, you carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Can't do business without it these days. Especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, really know how to inspire confidence, you know that? Oh, I forgot how nice this neighborhood was. You know something? One of these days, I'm gonna buy a house here.
Look at this guy.
I can tap X and it's fastest way slowing down.
Hey, what are you breaking my balls for? I'm just window shopping.
Or you could just crash, you know, that slows you down pretty quick too.
You got champagne tastes and beer pockets, my friend. Don't worry though, I'm gonna help you change that.
I need to just stop singing and actually talk. Oh crap, cut car over my head. Gotta slow it down. I love this speed limit, so this should be in more games. I'm going for a red light there. They don't care about that one.
It's that cream-colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
What if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
Like he's taking my car back.
Hey, what the fuck are you doing over there?
Ah, shit.
Okay, I did not see you. Fuck you, prick. Get up. Okay, good shot. Just get hurt, thank you. Took your time.
Hey! Hey, what you doing, motherfucker?
So racist. There's one down. Got another one to go. Oh crap, there's one man there. You lucky motherfucker. There you go. Pull us back, I got the shot. I want the car in good condition. Okay. Oh, saying I want it in good condition here so everybody can... Oh, Jesus! I just stood like a mother... Words I can't say. Hold on. I'm sure you won't mind a few, you know, bumps and scratches and bullet holes. I'm sure you won't mind that. Let me go down here, there's a police car. Oh, fucking hell. Can't handle like crap. Or I'm just a terrible driver. Hey, it doesn't straighten up when he's driving. Oh, there he did it as I. Of course, because it's in the snow. Oh, I really did not think I was that close to that. I'm a terrible driver. Jesus, this episode's gone in a long time. I think after I've done this, it's probably going to be the end of it. Go on, drive. Car sound cooler. Call the police quick. See how fast this car can go. Ah, come on police, really? Why ruin it? Going downhill, you can pick up the speed more. Speed limit 20. No, 40.
How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunt is their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I'd give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. I'll see you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted.
I thought you crashed my car then. Yeah, I crashed my car. I swear I didn't crash it. We'll drive Jay back and hoping that's the end of it, because Jesus, this is long. It's such a long time, just for one mission. I guess they do it in chapters.
We should take the highway, Vito.
Oh, he's turning right.
Right, you pulled off that job without fucking it up. Nice going.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked. I didn't live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
I guess you're right.
Don't worry.
Let's see how fast we can get the car going. Without these bends, it'll be a lot easier. We've got to turn off.
So, what's the story with Bruski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time he was at the track and some miss spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. Lousy pup.
Forgot it was snow. I probably should have braked sooner.
Just got an out of hand, please. Mike's a pussy.
I'll get used to it.
A safe place to park around here. I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage. The streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
And a friendly guy.
Okay, that's cool. Yeah, tell me that after I'm already pulling into the other one. Game, seriously. 31 minute recording. Where's Joe? He's just not going to talk to me. How many flights was it?
You're
this
hungry,
one?
There's some food in the refrigerator.
I don't even remember. Yeah, it was.
You're hungry, Vito? Take whatever you want from the fridge.
I'll take that. Over a sandwich. Take a sandwich. Real food. Okay, I'm hoping this is the end of this video. But I will be checking. Oh crap, I just hit the microphone. That's probably very loud. We've already finished another chapter. I think that will definitely be the end of the video then. I'll see you guys next episode. It is saving the top right. I probably couldn't notice that before. Wait, no cutscene? Don't be a cutscene. Don't do that to me. No. Okay, there you go. Okay, hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, leave it a like. If you want to see more, then subscribe. And I'll see you guys next episode.